doors, the UConn campus exploded. The North End, known as the Jungle, lived up to its nickname as students, crazed by the excitement, celebrated around a bonfire of burning dorm furniture.
Hey, we're great, yeah! We won, we're champions!
Number one, we're the best! We're the best!
The victory party was school-wide. Fans who saw their team finish the regular season in last place suddenly saw what it's like to be number one.
I think it's great that everybody's showing such school spirit. I think it's wonderful.
Several hundred students were waiting outside the field house when finally, around 3:30 in the morning, the bus carrying the team home from Madison Square Garden pulled in. The Huskies could count on a well-deserved hero's welcome.
Utah Huskies!
We did what we had to do to win. And we have this to come home to. It's great.
MVP! MVP! MVP!
The fans deserve a lot of this credit because they helped us through it, the hard times and the rough time, and we just went out and worked hard and just worked.
NIT victory. It's been 2 years since Jim Calhoun took over the UConn basketball program. Tonight he is being called the man who led a Cinderella team to the number one position. Needless to say, this was a very happy day for Coach Jim Calhoun, who sat down and talked with us at UConn today as he was preparing to fly to Kansas City for the NCAA championships.
I guess we'd have to call you Coach Cinderella today.
Something like that, you know.
How do those glass slippers fit?
They fit great. I tell you what, you don't want to take them off, but the reality will set in somewhere down the line, but I'm not going to let it for a couple days. We're just going to really enjoy this one, and I'm going to defer all questions about future expectations and anything else to the future.
You know, when the buzzer went off and UConn won the game, and you guys are, or we are, the NIT champs, what did you think at that exact moment? Did a lot of stuff come back to you?
Yeah, I really did. Just when I first got here and really getting to the point of, you know, what we tried to accomplish. And we really didn't set, like, particular goals for ourselves, just to try to get the program to be competitive, get the kids to do what we asked them to do, both academically and socially and certainly basketball-wise, and just kind of all kinds of feelings about being happy for the kids.
When the buzzer went off and Murray Williams threw the ball in the air, and Coach said, if you don't get MVP, I don't know who should get it. And I said, I looked at him and I shook his hand, and he said, I'm proud of you.
Oh, how'd that make you feel?
I just feel great.
Last night, very symbolic when Cliff Robinson, our best player, fouls up and gets in foul trouble with 15 minutes to go. We don't skip a beat.
I was kind of upset, you know, but I was sitting on the bench and I realized what kind of job my teammates were doing out there. You know, they were doing a great job. You know, they were controlling the ball, you know, rebounding everything. You know, I couldn't really complain, you know, about me not playing because, you know, they were doing all the good things we need to do.
The end of the season, UConn wasn't doing so great. We get an invitation to the NIT and people going, UConn, sort of screwing their noses up, like, what are they doing there? What do you want to say to those people now? Do you feel sort of like, nah, 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 or you're not really that kind of guy?
No, I just, we were just happy to be invited, and we legitimately felt we deserved to be invited. I don't think there's any question. We played in the best conference in America, and so I never ever felt about whether we should or should not.
Critics.
Yeah, but that's every place, and I think that one thing we try to establish from day one is the barometers of success and failure, barometers of what's right and what's wrong, will always be determined with inside the walls of our locker room.
One of the great things about you, Coach, that many, and you've got many fans that say, is you stress the academics.
The only thing I asked them to do for me, and they said, Coach, thanks, this can't exist. I said, be in class in the morning, because it lets everybody know that yeah, it was great, and the win is terrific, but that great balance between academics and athletics is so important to us, and, you know, they're trying, and we want to let them know we're trying on our end.
He's the type of man you want to play for, and you respect him with the utmost respect, so when he speaks from his heart, and you kind of take it to heart, and you want to do what's best for not only yourself, but for him, because he would do anything for you.
So when he said, go to class, what did you say?
Anything you want.
Was there any doubt in your mind that you would win the NIT? I mean, once it started?
You know, until the game starts, I never think I can win the game, and as soon as they throw the ball up, I don't think we can ever lose. And I think that's the kind of funny thing. I worry all the things that go wrong, and I think it helps motivate me and helps me prepare so I can try to take care of everything. Once we throw the ball up, I always feel we can win every game we're in, and that's always been my philosophy.
You can't take back what we won, but we've gained a lot from it, and that's probably...
What do you mean?
Respect, you know, and honor for our school.
The human spirit's a pretty strong thing. If you believe enough, sometimes good things do happen.
Didn't you like that guy? I asked him, do you feel pressure now for next year? Because after all, everybody's...
The NCAA tournament, too. Why not? They're on a roll.
That's right.
It's been something special. You know, they played everybody close this year, but they still finished ninth out of nine teams in the Big East. Then came that bid to the NIT, and something came alive in the Huskies, something that carried them to the championship. Only James Brown can put it into words.
I feel good. I knew that I would not. I feel good. I knew that I would not. So good, so good. I got a year. Wow, I feel nice. A sugar and spice. I feel nice. A sugar and spice. I feel nice, a sugar and spice. Sugar and spice. I feel nice. A sugar and spice. So nice, so nice that I got it here. Wow!
On a winning note.
20 wins.
Only two teams will do that in Division One.
Oh,
and I got to show you this.
There,
oh, I'll tell you.
All
didn't take long for this to happen, huh? This is the, well, you can see it right there. Now, I got to tell you, this is not the genuine article, and the University of Connecticut is not too pleased that these are out already because they own the rights to the NIT logo and the Husky. Some enterprising young person, entrepreneur took it upon
bring us one?
Him or herself to print these up last night right after the game.
A business major.
At all.
A business major, right.
Collector's item. I got one. But support your local state university. Go out and buy the real thing when they come out. Coach Jim Calhoun and his guys have been saying all along that they are better than their record shows, and we should have listened. They were absolutely right. They may not care about this in other parts of the country, but around here, it's never been any bigger or any better than this. And a lot of people are convinced this is just the beginning for UConn.
I feel wonderful right now, you know. It does signify how far our program is coming in, you know, just this short little time.
There's only two champions in the world, and we're the first champions. Now Monday night, there'll be another champion.
Ah, I can just hear the cynics now, can't you, saying, well, that's fine and dandy, but it was only the NIT, not the NCAAs. Well, you can take that notion and drop it right in the circular file, folks, because the Huskies finally have something they can really be proud of. Now, last night was easily the most exciting moment in UConn basketball history. But what they should really be excited about is the future, because the Huskies finally have one.
Well, in general, the NIT doesn't have the prestige of the NCAA. But for our program right now, it's a very, very important step. It's a step forward, a step into the so-called national spotlight. You know, we badly need that. And so I think it's very significant for us.
You know, until now, Coach Calhoun and his staff had some pretty decent recruiting enticements. They could talk about the Big East, the media exposure, the brand new sports complex that's about to be completed. But I'll tell you, what happened last night at Madison Square Garden, that is a coach's dream come true.
A lot of times you talk to different recruits and you say, hey, it's going to happen up there, it's going to happen up there. Well, some of it happened already, so now you can tangibly say, hey, we played this stage, and if you come here, maybe get to another stage.
It certainly is a help to our recruiting. You want to stay in the national spotlight as long as you possibly can. Being in the championship game of the NIT, there are only four other teams that are still playing, and they're in the NCAA Final Four. So we're on national television, on cable, and that was a wonderful thing for us. It's really a very positive step.
Does what happened last night exceed your expectations?
It did exceed my expectations. It certainly didn't exceed my hopes. You know, they're two different things. I expect a lot from our basketball program. It's going to be our leader. It's going to take us where we really want to go as a university, as an athletic program. What happened last night will be a positive thing for our women's programs as well as our men's, for football, for soccer. It's just a real shot in the arm for this institution.
All righty.
Skip-ball.
Everybody's excited about the university and everybody's talking about the game.
I graduated in 1973. Uh-huh. And I've been waiting for this long before that.
The Huskies of Connecticut.
The big win was also a hot topic at the state Supreme Court.
I think the win really demonstrates a change in attitude at the university.
An attitude that stresses the importance of athletics, an attitude this member of the class of 58 wholeheartedly supports.
UConn basketball has always been the state sport, and I think that the state rallies behind UConn, and I think it'll be good for all of us.
The $27 million athletic complex currently under construction is a concrete example of the renewed commitment to excellence in athletics. And last night's win wasn't the only payoff. The increased national attention will no doubt lead to increased applications and increased contributions.
We've discovered in the course of the day that the win attracts a great deal of attention from corporate leaders.
How much money will this mean for UConn? No one's saying. But there is one thing this victory has brought to Connecticut, and that's something money can't buy. Pride.
It feels really good. It hasn't worn off yet.
It's really neat to see the whole UConn campus get together for something like this.
I've never experienced anything like this before.
We went from being the least in the East to being the beast of the East.
Jenny Musanti, Channel 3 Eyewitness News, Storrs.
Well, even Governor O'Neill got down to the game last night to be part of the Cinderella story. UConn's first national title, a season with 20 victories, a coach in his second year, two players coming off suspensions last season, and this year a last place finish in the Big East Conference, now the NIT title. Does this put added pressure on the team next year? Channel 3's Gail King put the question to Coach Calhoun.
I didn't think I had to top anything. I just really didn't this year. I just felt like I had to do the best I can do, and one of our things is that, hey, when the 2 hours is over before a game, we say to them, we have to look each other in the eye. And so, like next year, when the season's over, we have to look each other in the eye. And so the barometer will always be us, not what other people expect, because they are not doing it, we're doing it. And they support us, and they've been tremendous. Our fans have been absolutely super. But the most important thing is that we'll always judge each other, and we'll always be able to look each other in the eye and say, hey, we gave it our best.
Championship high
team beat Boston College 11-4.
See, it never stopped. We're on a roll.
Bad week for Boston College, too. Oh, back to the NIT. Was there ever any doubt, huh? Well, there wasn't in my mind. They've simply been playing so well of late. There was no way they weren't going to win. They made it interesting in the final moments, but credit Ohio State for much of that. The NIT championship caps a great year for Jim Calhoun, a nice way for Jeff King to go out, and something to build on for the returnees next fall. Phil Andrews reports from New York.
From Greenwich to Salisbury, from Groton to Hartford, the word is out. But I tell you, it wasn't easy. UConn's top dog, Cliff Robinson, was in foul trouble, and to make matters worse, the Ohio State Buckeyes were doing a great job of finding the basket, as Curtis Wilson tied the game at 46 with two on the fast break here. But like the other four games of the NIT, the Huskies would eventually take control, with Steve Peichel putting Connecticut up for good with one from the three times as nice stripe, en route to claiming the school's first ever NIT title with a 72-67 victory.
There are hundreds of seniors across the country that would love to be in that seat right now. And how do you feel to be the only person?
It feels really good. We went out winners, and I'm only two teams going to go out winners in the nation, and I'm one of them.
We went out, we played well this year. I mean, we deserve to come to the NIT and deserve the winners.
For Phil Gamble, the game was extra special, not only because of the victory, but because of tournament officials fittingly dubbing him the NIT most valuable player, much to the pleasure of his teammates and head coach Jim Calhoun.
I knew that there'd be good players and really good to our program when things went negative for them last year. You know, a lot of kids would quit about talking about transferring and all the other stuff, and all they said simply was, we're gonna be with coach next year.
When do you think this is finally gonna sink in that Tate George and the UConn Huskies won the NIT?
Maybe Friday when I get back to New Jersey to talk to my mother. You know, I got tears in my chest and in my eyes because she's done so much for me.
Right now, we're all so emotionally high that you know, anything can happen right now. It just wouldn't faze us because we're on top of the world.
The team has a lot more to accomplish, and, you know, we're going to set higher standards for ourselves and, you know, come back, you know, ready to play next year.
And so with last night's victory over Ohio State, the UConn Huskies closed the book on a fairy tale season, a season that only some teams dream about. At Madison Square Garden, I'm Phil Andrews, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
And, of course, just about everybody remotely connected to the triumph at Madison Square Garden with the Huskies, except one.
What were your thoughts the other night, Coach, when you saw him throw the ball up in the air and the NIT comes to the Huskies?
Well, I think it goes immediately to the players, Dave. In particular, the tallest guy on the floor at that time, Jeff King. I call him Kinger because he's had some rocky moments and yet probably saved his best to the end. So, and then seeing him standing on top of the basket, it's a good thing he only weighs 190 pounds because it would have came down. But really delighted inside, personally, for him. And, of course, I can go on and on. He, Phil Gamble, Clifford, Robert Urs, Rita Spider. And, of course, Tater and Pike were two kids that we recruited that last year I was there. So you have to feel elated for the kids.
So your heart was with them when you were watching the game.
I saw him play very often this year. If I wasn't at the game, I watched all of them on television, or I'm right in the car, listen to radio, struggle to get them on the radio at times, but certainly followed them. I think they, when you've recruited kids and gone into their homes, talked to their families, become close with their families, you don't just forget about them. And I think that's, you know, one aspect I think I pride myself on, that I cared about the players very deeply, and obviously seeing these kids do what they've done, you know, makes me feel good personally.
This is, it was fun. We must have some pride the other night.
When you see six kids that you dealt with for a long time doing it, hey, you say, you know what, we weren't that far away. And yet, as I told the kids when I left, what I'm doing today is going to help you. I think it did.
Dom Perno, who again was awfully proud of those kids too when they won the other night.